यस मैम,
यस मैम,
आई एम ऑडिबल नाउ?
यस
यस
मैम,
मैम. ओके, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग टुडे. वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द क्रेब साइकिल. क्रेब साइकिल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए टी सी ए साइकिल. टी सी ए मीन्स इट इज ट्राई कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड साइकिल और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ए सिट्रिक एसिड साइकिल. सो यू हैव थ्री नेम्स फॉर वन साइकिल. इट इज ए टी सी ए और क्रेब्स और सिट्रिक एसिड साइकिल. नाउ यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन द ग्लाइकोलिसिस और द ई एम पी पाथवे. इन दैट द ग्लूकोज वॉज ऑक्सीडाइज टू पायरुविक एसिड एंड पायरुविक एसिड इज द एंड प्रोडक्ट ऑफ ग्लाइकोलिसिस. सो दैट पायरुवेट विच इज जनरेटेड वाया एरोबिक ग्लाइकोलिसिस नाउ फीड्स इन टू द टी सी ए साइकिल और द क्रेब्स साइकिल. But what happens if there is no sufficient amount of oxygen? It means that when there is no amount of oxygen, sufficient of oxygen, or in absence of sufficient oxygen, the pyruvate enters into the anaerobic glycolysis, or you call it as a fermentation pathway. So in that case, pyruvate is reduced by NADH via anaerobic glycolysis or fermentation, and a wide range of products usually are obtained. Those products usually are lactic acid or lactate in animals and ethanol in yeast. So these are the end products generated when there is absence of sufficient oxygen and the pyruvate is reduced to either lactic acid in animals or ethanol in yeast. But in aerobic conditions, the pyruvate is entering into the mitochondria, and in mitochondria complete oxidation takes place. So it is oxidized, the pyruvate is oxidized by oxygen into carbon dioxide and water, and whatever the chemical energy is liberated, that chemical energy is conserved in the form of ATP. So pyruvate, which is generated via aerobic glycolysis, it feeds into the citric acid cycle or TCA cycle or the Krebs cycle. And this cycle was first discovered as a pathway of pyruvate oxidation in animal tissues, and it was discovered by Hans Krebs in 1937. So in 1937, Hans Krebs discovered this pathway. But how did he get the idea that this cycle is a cyclic one and not a straight one like glycolytic pathway? Glycolytic pathway is a linear pathway, but Krebs cycle is a cycle one. So he did his study, during his study of effect of anions of various organic acids on the rate of oxygen consumption during pyruvate oxidation by a suspension of minced pigeon breast muscle. So he was doing his study with the suspension of minced, means that is macerated, means kutne ke baad pigeon breast muscles ki study kar rahe the. So these muscle, why did he use? He used this muscle because during a flight, when the birds fly, usually they have a higher rate of respiration, and therefore it was a appropriate for the study of oxidative activity. And this high rate of respiration is usually observed when the birds fly, and therefore these particular muscles were macerated or minced in order to study the oxidative Krebs cycle or the citric acid cycle. So during the aerobic condition, usually the glycolysis product, that is your pyruvic acid or the pyruvate, it forms a acetyl CoA. So this acetyl CoA is technically not a part of citric acid cycle because it is shown at the top left of the diagram. But acetyl CoA, whether from glycolysis or from fatty acid spiral, see, you can obtain the acetyl CoA from glycolysis okay, or you can obtain the acetyl CoA from fatty acid spiral, and it is usually the initiator of the citric acid cycle. So this is your citric acid cycle. See, it is not a part, that is acetyl CoA is not a part of citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle starts with the citrate, okay. But what happens, the pyruvate is first converted to the acetyl CoA in the glycolysis pathway, or it can come from the fatty acid degradation or fatty acid degradation. Then this acetyl CoA is having carbon 2. What happens to this carbon 2 acetyl CoA? In presence of water and acetyl CoA comes out, it forms a citrate with adding the C4 oxaloacetate. So C4 plus C2, it forms a C6 citrate molecule. Means acetyl CoA is the starting material. It combines with the oxaloacetate and it forms the citrate or the citric acid, and therefore this cycle is called as a citric acid cycle. So this is your first 6 carbon compound, that is citric acid. Later on, this citric acid or the citrate is getting converted into isocitrate. This is also a 6 carbon compound and it is a isomerized form of citrate. Later on, from isocitrate, the NAD is getting reduced with elimination of carbon dioxide, means one carbon is lost here, and therefore the isocitrate having C carbon is now forming alpha ketoglutarate, which is a 5 carbon atom. Okay, so this alpha ketoglutarate again is undergoing a reduction in which NAD positive is getting reduced to NADH plus H plus, and acetyl CoA is given out, and therefore that is carbon dioxide is eliminated. So one carbon has got again eliminated out, so it has lost one carbon, okay, and now from C5 it has again lost one carbon, so it has formed C4 succinyl CoA. So in presence of acetyl CoA and the NAD reduced to NADH plus H plus, it forms a succinyl CoA. Now this succinyl CoA C4 compound, in presence of GDP or ADP, here you have a conversion, that is from GDP to GTP or from ADP to ATP, and this is what is called as a substrate level phosphorylation. The conversion or phosphorylation of ADP or GDP to GTP or ATP is called as a substrate level phosphorylation. So that you will get a succinate or the succinic acid. This succinic acid is a C4 compound. Now what happens? This C4 compound is again undergoing a reduction of FAD into FADH2. So usually this particular reaction is of a electron transport chain, okay. So this, from ubiquinone, this ubiquinone is getting reduced, okay, and this oxidized ubiquinone, when it is getting reduced, what happens, this particular FADH2 is giving the FADH2 is giving the hydrogens to ubiquinone, and because of this the ubiquinone gets reduced. But from where it is acquiring the hydrogen? It is acquiring the hydrogen from this pathway. So FAD, it was oxidized, in oxidized state, but when it is gaining the hydrogens or electrons, then it is getting reduced, and this reduced hydrogen is passing to the, that is ubiquinones, okay. So later on what happens, succinate is getting converted to the fumarate. This is also a carbon 4 compound. Now this fumarate, in presence of this process is the hydrolysis, in which water molecule is added, and fumarate is getting converted to malate, that is C4 compound. Now again from malate you will get the oxaloacetate, that is C4 compound. But here again NAD positive is reduced to NADH plus H plus, okay. So where do you get, you have 3 NAD positive plus NADH plus H plus. Okay, so this is your first step, second step, and third step. NAD positive is getting reduced to NADH plus H plus, and you have one molecule of FAD which is getting reduced, that is FADH2, and you will get one ADP or GTP, GDP getting phosphorylated to ATP or GTP. Now, this cycle, it is a cyclic cycle in which the oxaloacetate in presence of acetyl-CoA is getting converted to citrate to isocitrate, alpha-ketoglutarate, succinyl-CoA, succinate, fumarate, malate, oxaloacetate. Again, this oxaloacetate is entering into the chain by taking the another acetyl-CoA, which is derived from the pyruvate molecule, that is from the glycolysis. Okay, so this cycle, Krebs cycle, is continuing on. Now, what is the aim of this Krebs cycle, or what is the function of this Krebs cycle? What happens? The alpha-ketoglutarate is a precursor molecule. What do you understand by the precursor molecule? Precursor molecule means it is the molecule from which other amino acids or organic acids or fatty acids or different steroid molecules are synthesized. So, these are the precursor molecules. So, usually the alpha-ketoglutarate is a precursor molecule or the starting material. Precursor means it is the starting material from which you will synthesize the microorganism or human beings synthesize their amino acids. So, biosynthesis of amino acids like glutamate takes place. Also, they synthesize the nucleotides also, like ATP, GTP, etc. So, this glutamate is the precursor for other amino acid synthesis as well as for the synthesis of nucleotides, purines and pyrimidine nucleotides. Okay. Then citrate is a precursor for the synthesis of fatty acids and sterols. Succinyl-CoA is a precursor for forming the porphyrins, rings, or the, you know, that heme protein in the hemoglobin. That heme protein is also obtained from the succinyl-CoA and in the chlorophyll. So, they are acting as a coenzymes or a part of the porphyrin rings, or the heme or the chlorophyll molecule. Similarly, you will see that the oxaloacetate is forming, or it is undergoing the biosynthesis of amino acid, that is aspartate. And from aspartate, you get other amino acids as well as the nucleotide biosynthesis. So, in this way, when the Krebs cycle is continuing in the human, animals, or in the bacterial cell, usually it supplies the precursor molecules for the synthesis of amino acids, for the synthesis of fatty acids and sterols, or for the synthesis of nucleotides, or as a coenzyme group in case of porphyrins, hemes, and chlorophyll molecule. Okay, so now we'll see in detail all these steps. So, in carbohydrate metabolism, acetyl-CoA is the link between glycolysis and citric acid cycle. As I have said, this is particularly the acetyl-CoA, and this acetyl-CoA is acting so the initiating step of citric acid cycle occurs when four carbon compounds oxaloacetic, it condenses with two carbon compound, that is acetyl-CoA, to form the citric acid. So first is the citric acid cycle. How citric acid is formed? That is, citric acid is formed when the acetyl-CoA condenses with the four carbon compound, that is oxaloacetate. The whole purpose of the turn of the citric acid cycle is to produce two carbon dioxide molecules. You have seen that there is production of two carbon compounds. So, you you have seen that there is production of two carbon dioxide molecules. This one carbon dioxide and this is the another. From isocitrate to alpha ketoglutarate you will get one elimination of carbon dioxide, and from alpha ketoglutarate to succinyl CoA you will get the another molecule of carbon dioxide. Okay, then these general oxidation reaction, it is accompanied by the loss of hydrogen and electrons at four specific places. So what are those four specific spaces that we have seen? 3 NAD positive is getting reduced to NADH plus H plus, and one AD, that is FAD, is getting reduced to FADH2. Okay, so these are the three NAD molecules getting reduced to NADH plus H plus, and the that is the single FAD molecules getting reduced to FADH2. These oxidations, they are connected to the electron transport chain where many ATPs are usually produced. So when from NADH2 it is shedding or transferring the electrons to the electron transport system, and therefore you from one NADP, one NADH2 molecules, you will get three molecules of ATP. So when one NAD is reduced to NADH plus H plus proton, you will have that NADH when it is moving in transferring its electron in the electron transport system, three molecules of ATP are generated. And since we have three NAD positive getting reduced to NADH plus protons, in total how many ATPs are formed? How many ATPs are formed? That is 3 into 3, 9 ATPs are formed. Okay. So this reaction, the reaction for citric acid cycle, are shown in the graphic on the left that I have explained you. Now these reactions, usually they are more familiar than those from glycolysis. So unless the instructor states otherwise, you should study these reactions. Therefore you should know how many ATPs can be formed, how many carbon dioxide is generated, how to name the type of reactions at each step, and how to write down the structure of any compound which can be blanked out. Or you should know, for that you should not mug up or you should not memorize, you should understand the compound structure and you should keep it in mind. So this is your citric acid cycle in detail. So see here, I have explained you that is citric acid is the first product which is formed by condensation of oxalic acid or oxaloacetate with the acetyl CoA. Okay, it is directly entering from the glycolysis or from fatty acid spiral. Then later on, the citric acid is converted into cis aconitic acid, and later on it is converted to isocitrate. So this is the structure of cis aconitic acid, and then this is the structure of isocitric acid. So when NADH plus H plus is formed, it is going to the electron transport chain. So when pyruvate, this is your pyruvate compound CH3COCOOH, in presence of acetyl CoA and NAD, you will lose one carbon and you will get acetyl CoA. Okay. And carbon dioxide is given out, and NADH plus, this NAD has got reduced. So this NADH is entering into the electron transport chain and it will give you 3 ATP molecules. Okay. Then from isocitrate to oxalosuccinic acid or succinyl CoA, then this is the compound. So here NAD positive is getting reduced to NADH. Again it is going to electron transport chain and you will get 3 ATP molecules. Then in this succinyl CoA, the carbon dioxide is given out. Then this is your alpha ketoglutarate. From alpha ketoglutarate it is eliminating one carbon dioxide, and NAD positive is reduced to NADH, and this reduced NADH is moving into the electron transport chain, And here also again three ATPs are formed when it is entering into the electron transport chain. Later on, this succinyl-CoA, that is succinyl-CoA, when it is forming the succinic acid, ADP or GDP is converted to ATP or GTP. And this succinic acid or the succinate, in this case, there is another substrate level this is your substrate level phosphorylation, where ADP is getting converted to ATP or GDP is getting converted to GDP. Then this is your reducing agent, that is flavin, adenosine, dinucleotide. So this flavin, adenosine, dinucleotide is reduced to FADH2. And when it is reduced to FADH2, it also enters into the electron transport chain. And when it enters into the electron transport chain, here you have only two ATP molecules generated. See, when NAD is reduced to NADH plus H plus, then you get three molecules of ATP generation. But when there is a FAD, then you will get only two molecules of ATP. Then this fumaric acid or the fumarate is converted to malic acid or the malate, and then from malate to the, that is oxaloacetic acid or oxaloacetate. So this oxaloacetate is once again entering into the Krebs cycle. So this is your complete Krebs cycle or the citric acid cycle. So here you have got, that is when the pyruvate is converted to acetyl-CoA and losing carbon dioxide, and NAD is getting reduced to NADH plus proton, three ATP molecules. So you have one NAD positive, NADH, second, third, and fourth. So because of four NAD positive or the oxidized state is reduced to NADH plus proton, you will have 12 ATP molecules generated, plus here you have 2 ATP molecules. So in total you have, that is 14 ATP molecules. Understood? So 14 ATP molecules, and net gain of ATP in glycolysis is 2. Net gain is 2. So now since you have two pyruvate molecules entering here, so what happens, 14 into 2 times means you will have, that is 20, 14 into 2, that is 28 ATP molecules generated. So now we are coming to the reactions of the synthesis of, that is citric acid, the first reaction, how the citric acid is synthesized in presence of enzyme citric acid synthase. So one thing you should note, that you should not memorize the structures but derive them from a knowledge of reaction principle. So you should know what is the structure of oxaloacetate, what is the structure of acetyl-CoA. So how to keep it in mind, acetyl-CoA? First, you keep it in mind the structure of pyruvate. Pyruvate is nothing but CH3COCOH. Okay. So, this CH3COCOH is the pyruvate molecule. What it is doing? It is losing carbon dioxide. So, it will form a acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA means CH3CO. Okay. So, this acetyl-CoA, when it condenses with the oxaloacetate, it forms a citric acid. So this acetyl group CH3CO, CO negative, COO negative, is transferred from CoA to oxaloacetate at the ketone carbon, and therefore then it is changing to the alcohol group. So here what happens, the net effect is to join two carbon piece with the four carbon piece and to generate a six carbon compound, that is the citric acid. So this is the first synthesis of citric acid, and therefore this particular reaction, it is catalyzed by the citric acid synthase. The second reaction is the dehydration of alcohol. So there is formation of cis aconitic acid, means it is a dehydration step. So the two steps are required to isomerize the position of OH group on the citric acid to form the that is isocitrate molecule. So first step is dehydration of the alcohol to make it alkyne, so that it forms the cis acetonic acid, which remains bound to the enzyme acetonase in readiness for the next step. And this reaction usually is catalyzed by the acetonase enzyme. Then third step is the hydration to make the alcohol, and this reaction is a hydration reaction of an alkyl to make an alcohol. So, but this particular hydration process does not follow the Markovnikov rule, and the net effect of reactions 2 and 3 has been to remove the OH group from C3 to carbon 2, which is isocitric acid. So, the ultimate aim is to produce the isocitrate, and this reaction is catalyzed by presence of enzyme acetonase. The fourth reaction is the oxidation. So, the oxidation, first oxidation reaction occurs, which converts the alcoholic group into a ketonic group, and two hydrogens and two electrons are transferred to Na positive, so that it becomes reduced, that is NADH plus proton, and this is the entry point into the electron transport chain. So, the product of this reaction, oxalosuccinate, it remains attached to the isocitrate dehydrogenase for the next step. However, this reaction is catalyzed by isocitrate dehydrogenase. The next reaction is reaction 5, which is a decarboxylation in which the carbon dioxide is eliminated out by decarboxylation reaction. And because of the elimination of one carbon in the form of carbon dioxide, it forms a 5-carbon compound which is called as alpha-ketoglutaric acid or alpha-ketoglutarate. And this formation of alpha-ketoglutarate is catalyzed by the enzyme isocitrate dehydrogenase. The sixth reaction is a combination of oxidation reaction, decarboxylation reaction, then thioester synthesis. So, how it occurs? The first reaction is the oxidative decarboxylation, means there is removal of one carbon in the form of carbon dioxide, and it is guided by three enzymes. So, usually this particular reaction occurs with formation of acetyl CoA from pyruvic acid. It is very similar. So, what happens? The oxidation of alcohol takes place and is converted to ketone, and two hydrogen and two electrons are transferred to NAD positive to NADH plus H plus, and this is the another entry point into the electron transport chain. Now, usually this is a only non-reversible step in the entire cycle. Every step is reversible. They can move in forward direction as well as in the backward direction, but the formation of that is alpha-ketoglutarate to succinyl-CoA. Alpha-ketoglutarate to succinyl-CoA is a irreversible step. That it means. Okay. So, this is the second step where a carbon group is lost in the form of carbon dioxide, and therefore it is called as a decarboxylation reaction. So, essentially, although not exact same carbon, the two carbons from the acetyl CoA have been converted to carbon dioxide at the end of this step. So, here again there is a remaining 4 carbon compounds attached to the CoA, and therefore it is called as a succinyl CoA, because the CoA group or the coenzyme group is attached with the thioester formation, and this thioester is a high energy bond in the succinyl CoA. So, this succinyl CoA has 4 carbons in the succinate group at one end of the CoA, and this reaction is carried out or it is catalyzed by alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase complex. So, it is called as a complex. Why it is called as a complex? Because 3 reactions are taking place. One is the oxidation, second is the decarboxylation, and third is the hydroxylation process. Okay. Then reaction 7 is hydrolysis of succinyl CoA2, and there is a synthesis of ATP. Now, usually the hydrolysis of thioester bond is exothermic. Exothermic means it has the ability to shed off the thermal energy. Okay, means when the ADP molecule comes in contact, the ADP molecule is getting phosphorylated. Actually, that is the GTP molecule is formed first, but is further coupled with the ADP molecule, and therefore ADP is converted to ATP molecule. And this is the only visible ATP formed in the entire cycle. See, for in example of glycolysis, you will see that there is two substrate level phosphorylation in which ADP is directly phosphorylated to ATP molecules. But in Krebs cycle, directly the direct formation of ATP is only possible in this step, that is reaction number 7 or the step number 7, in which ADP is converted to ATP with transfer of, that is, phosphate molecule from from GTP to ADP, and then ATP is getting converted to ATP molecule. Then succinic acid, a 4-carbon compound, is a product of this reaction, and this is the start of the return to the beginning of the cycle. So now it is again this is the start. Now it has got converted into 4-carbon compound, and from succinate you will get the fumarate, then from fumarate you will get the malate, and from malate you will get the, that is, oxaloacetate. So this is your start of the return of the beginning of the cycle. Means from this succinic acid, actually again the cycle is being completed or entering into the new cycle, that is the Krebs cycle. So this reaction is usually catalyzed by succinyl coenzyme A. The 8th reaction is the oxidation. This slightly unusual oxidation reaction takes place, in which there is removal of hydrogen from the saturated alkyl carbon, and it forms a alkene which is called as the fumaric acid. Later on, the hydrogen acceptor is the coenzyme FAD, and this FAD you will find instead of NAD positive. So this will be significant when ATP is tabulated from the electron transport chain, and therefore this particular coenzyme forms only 2 ATP molecules, NAD H plus protons. When it is entering into the electron transport chain, it forms 3 molecules of ATP, but when FAD is reduced to FADH2, only 2 ATP molecules are generated from this reaction in the electron transport chain. The 8th reaction or the 8th step is catalyzed by succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. The 9th reaction is hydration. Now there is addition of water molecule, or the hydration of fumarate to malate. And so what happens, the alkene group is converted to the alcohol in presence of water, and now you can place the OH group, that is the OH group, adjacent to the carboxylic acid group in either case, and you can form a malic acid. So this reaction usually is catalyzed by the fumarate. So fumarate is getting converted into the malic acid or the malate, and from malate the last step is the oxidation. Once again there is a final reaction, that is the oxidation of alcohol to a ketone to make the oxaloacetic. The coenzyme NAD positive causes the transfer of 2 hydrogens and 2 electrons to NADH plus H plus, and this is again the final entry point into the electron transport chain, and this reaction is catalyzed by malate dehydrogenase, and from oxaloacid and from, that is, malate, you will get the generation of oxaloacetate. Now this oxaloacetate is entering once again, starting with the acetyl CoA and 2-carbon, that is the acetyl CoA with 2-carbon forms the citric acid, and the citric acid spins these 2 carbons off as 2-carbon dioxide. So in every Krebs cycle there is a generation of 2-carbon dioxide molecules, In aerobic organism, citric acid cycle is an amphibolic pathway. It serves both catabolic and anabolic processes. It means that the citric acid is a that is, it is a amphibolic pathway, means it can serve as a catabolic processes as well as it can serve as a anabolic process. Catabolic processes means when it undergoes a degradation, you will get the energy, and this certain precursor molecules like alpha ketoglutarate, then that is the oxaloacetate forms the aspartate, and from aspartate you get number of amino acids. From alpha ketoglutarate you get number of amino acids, nucleotides, and also the from citrate you get different fatty acids and sterol groups. So it not only functions in oxidative catabolism of carbohydrates, fatty acids and amino acids, but it also provides precursor for many biosynthetic pathways. So already we have discussed, by the action of several important auxiliary enzymes, certain intermediates of citric acid cycles, particularly the alpha ketoglutarate and oxaloacetate, can be removed from the cycle and serve as the precursor of amino acids. So aspartate and glutamate have the same number of same carbon skeleton as oxaloacetate and alpha ketoglutarate respectively, and therefore they are used for synthesis of nucleotides, as well as they are synthesized from them by simple transamination reaction. So you can get aspargine, glutamine as the amino acids. Through aspartate and glutamate, the carbons of oxaloacetate and alpha ketoglutarate are used to build other amino acids, as well as the different nucleotides like purines and pyrimidine molecules. So we will see how oxaloacetate is converted into glucose in the process of gluconeogenesis. So you know, oxaloacetate can be degraded into glucose in the process of gluconeogenesis. Succinyl-CoA is the central intermediate in the synthesis of porphyrin ring of heme groups, which serves as the oxygen carrier in hemoglobin and myoglobin. Myoglobin is present in the muscles, as well as it is electron carriers in certain cytochromes observed in the prokaryotic cell. Given the number of biosynthetic products derived from citric acid cycle intermediates, this cycle clearly serves a critical role apart from its function in energy yielding metabolism. Means, apart from you are deriving the energy in the form of ATP molecules, the Krebs cycle is having certain intermediates which serves a critical important role in different biosynthetic pathways like amino acids, as well as in the photosynthesis of porphyrin rings, or as electron carrier molecules in the cytochrome molecules. Now we have seen that until this we have seen the Krebs cycle. Now what happens in prokaryotes? Different pathways are mixed together. Different pathways are mixed together. See, here glucose is when glucose is getting converted. This is your glycolysis. From glucose, that is glucokinase. Glucokinase is the enzyme. ATP is hydrolyzed, and you will get glucose 6-phosphate. Then you will get fructose 6-phosphate. From fructose 1,6-phosphate, then 1,6-phosphate, you will get two products, that is in presence of aldolase, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and the dihydroxyacetone phosphate. And this is interconvertible. So glyceraldehyde, from dihydroxyacetone phosphate you will get the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and then 1,3-phosphate. This is the complete glycolysis pathway. Got it clear? Now these glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate can be also obtained when glucose 6-phosphate is getting converted to 6-phosphogluconate, or from gluconate directly it is getting converted to 6-phosphogluconate. Okay. Then 6-phosphogluconate is getting converted to 2-keto-3-deoxy-6-phosphogluconate, that is KDPG, and then to the pyruvate pyruvate is reduced, and in presence of that aldolase enzyme, you will get glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So this is the second pathway. Okay, this is your first pathway. Then this is from glucose 6-phosphate, you will get this pathway, complete pathway, you will get the pyruvate. Another pathway is this pathway, that is this pathway is called as the ZWF pathway. Okay, and next is your in presence of glucose dehydrogenase, you will get gluconate. Then gluconate is converted to 6-phosphogluconate. Here ATP is again added and ADP is given out, and you will get 6-phosphogluconate. So then again the another pathway is this pathway. Okay, so this is your hexose pentose pathway. So here you have from 6-phosphogluconate there is formation of ribulose 5-phosphate, and then ribulose 5-phosphate is getting converted to ribose, then from ribose to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, then fructose 6-phosphate. Okay, and then this is getting converted to erythrose, pseudoheptulose, xylulose is added, and then you will get pseudoheptulose, then from pseudoheptulose you will get the erythrose, and this xylulose forms the fructose 6-phosphate. Okay, and this fructose 6-phosphate then again can undergo this particular cycle. So in this way, this whole or the complete cycles, they are shunted together. Means either the microorganism, if it has a limited amount of pyruvic acid from the glycolytic pathway, it can obtain from this EDA pathway. Okay, or it can obtain it from the GND. Okay, so from fructose 6-phosphate you will get glyceraldehyde phosphate, and from here you can obtain the pyruvate, or you can obtain it from this particular pathway. So all these processes, they can occur in the prokaryotic cell. So the most common glycolytic routes in the prokaryotes, EMP, often simply referred as glycolysis, is shown in red. See, this is your complete pathway, it is moving for the formation of pyruvate. Okay, then the OPP pathway is shown in blue with enzyme ZWF, and the ED pathway is shown in the green. So this is your ED pathway, Entner-Diodorov's pathway. So this is your EDD pathway, which is shown in green. The reactions that are shared by all the pathways are shown in black. The EMP and the OPP pathways are known to operate in the cyanobacteria and plants. So where do you find this particular pathways? The EMP and the OPP pathway is usually known to operate in cyanobacteria and plants. The ED pathway operates in cyanobacteria and plants. The EDA, that is KDPG aldolase, EDD phosphogluconate dehydrogenase, ENO means enolase, FBA means fructose bisphosphate aldolase, GDH means glucose dehydrogenase. These are the abbreviations which are representing the different enzyme molecules. See, these are the enzymes. So this is glucose dehydrogenase, GDH means. Then G6P hydrogenase, dehydrogenase. GND means, gluconate, GND, gluconate dehydrogenase. Likewise, you have this particular enzymes. What is RPE? What is RPI? These are all the enzymes. GAPDH. This is represented. The full form of this are represented here. So GDH is glucose dehydrogenase. GK is gluconate kinase. GND is 6-phosphogluconate dehydrogenase. PFK is 6-phosphofructokinase, PGI is phosphoglucoisomerase, PGK is phosphoglycerate kinase, RPE, I have said ribulose 5-phosphate epimerase, RPI, ribulose 5-phosphate isomerase, TAL is transaldolase, TIM is triose, triose phosphate isomerase, TKT is transketolase, ZWF is glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase. All these enzymes are represented here, which is carrying out different. This is talase, aldolase enzyme, this is ketolase enzyme, this is ketolase enzyme. Okay, so transketolase and transaldolases. So this is your pathway. So carbohydrate, glucose, fructose, galactose is entering into the glycolytic pathway, and how it is entering via formation of glucose 6 phosphate. Glucose 6 phosphate via process glycogenesis forms a glycogen and is stored in the liver. The glucose is stored in the liver in the form of a glycogen. Okay. But once it requires glucose, when the cell is short of the glucose and glucose molecule, then glycogen is converted back into glucose 6 phosphate via glycogenolysis. The process of conversion of glucose to glycogen is called as glycogenesis. And the process of conversion of glycogen to glucose 6 phosphate is glycogenolysis. Okay. Now, glucose 6 phosphate undergoes a glycolysis pathway. A number of intermediate steps you have to form a pyruvic acid. And this pyruvic acid can also be converted back into glucose 6 phosphate by gluconeogenesis. See, remember the names of these pathways. Okay. The pyruvate once again is can be converted into just wait a minute. This way the complete cycle is shown here. So pyruvate to oxaloacetate, pyruvate to acetyl CoA. The cycle is your complete Krebs cycle. Fatty acids and sterol formation, alpha ketoglutarate to formation of glutamate, and from glutamate you will get 3 amino acids, arginine, proline and glutamine. Also you will get the purine molecules. Succinyl CoA is a precursor molecule for porphyrins and heme protein. Then malate, pyruvate can also directly get reduced to malate or get converted to malate in presence of malic enzyme. And the oxaloacetate, it is a precursor for aspartate. From aspartate you get two amino acids, aspartic acid and aspargine, and also you will get the pyrimidines. Then this pyruvate decarboxylase enzyme is responsible for conversion of pyruvate to, that is, oxaloacetate. So, in presence of phosphoenol pyruvate, that is phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase, directly gets converted to oxaloacetate. So, this reaction is usually reversible reaction. It can move in forward or backward direction. That is, from oxaloacetate you can get the phosphoenol pyruvate, or from phosphoenol pyruvate you can get the oxaloacetate. So, in presence of phosphoenol pyruvate carboxy kinase, you will get oxaloacetate, and in presence of, that is, PEP carboxylase, you will get the, that is, phosphoenol pyruvate. So, phosphoenol pyruvate is a precursor molecule for the synthesis of amino acid serine, glycine, cysteine, phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan. So, from this, that is, Krebs cycle, all the intermediates of this TCA cycle or the citric acid cycle, they are paving the way for the biosynthesis of different amino acids, porphyrin and different fatty acids and sterol molecules, as well as in the biosynthesis of purines and pyrimidines, that is the nucleotides. So thank you. Hope you have understood today's lecture. If you have any doubt, please ask me the question now.